You don't joke about calling black men boys. Men like James O. Eastland use words like that and the racist policies that accompany them to perpetuate white supremacy and strip black Americans of our human, very humanity. Well, tonight, Joe Biden is saying it's Senator Booker who owes him an apology. Senator Booker joins me now here in studio. Thank you so much.
It's really good to be always back with you.
Yes. So listen, you know, I said he came back strong. I don't know if you think his defense was strong, but what do you think specifically?
Well, I was surprised that he didn't apologize for what he said. I was surprised that today he said Cory Booker should have known better and he should apologize.
Let's actually listen to him saying that.
Yeah.
I could not have disagreed with Jim Eastland more. And he was a segregationist. I ran for the United States Senate because I disagreed with the views of the segregationists, and many of them in the Senate at the time. As I led the Judiciary Committee, I was able to pass what I was talking about was the Voting Rights Act. I was able to pass the Voting Rights Act when I was a young senator, when he was still the chairman, we voted against him and beat him in the Voting Rights Act. The point I'm making is you don't have to agree. You don't have to like the people in terms of their views, but you just simply make the case and you beat them. You beat them without changing the system.
Are you going to apologize? Like Cory Booker
apologize for what?
Cory Booker's called for it.
Cory should apologize. He knows better. There's not a racist bone in my body. I've been involved in civil rights my whole career. Period. Period. Period.
Are you going to apologize?
The vice president said I should know better, and this is what I know. As a black man in America, I know the deeply harmful and hurtful usage of the word boy and how it was used to dehumanize and degrade. I know that segregationists like the two people you were talking about, through their laws and their language, deeply wounded this nation, and the present day manifestations of their work can still be seen in black and brown communities like the one I go home to. I know that running for president of the United States, somebody running to be the leader of our party, should know that using the word boy in the way he did can cause hurt and pain. And we need a presidential nominee and the leader of our party to be sensitive to that. And the last thing I know is I know that I was raised to speak truth to power and that I will never apologize for doing that. And Vice President Biden shouldn't need this lesson. And at a time when we have, from the highest offices in the land, divisiveness, racial hatred, and bigotry being spewed, he should have the sensitivity to know that this is a time I need to be an ally, I need to be a healer, I need to not engage in usage of words that will harm folks. And so this is deeply disappointing. We waited for him to apologize. He didn't till the next day. And whether I'm running for president or not, as many people today have been, on Juneteenth, no less, calling out for the vice president to acknowledge that his words were harmful and hurtful.
So that means no apology from you?
No.
As he said, you should apologize.
No.
What do you make of his defense about the original Voting Rights Act and all of his work that he's done with civil rights, he said?
Well, again, I don't understand why he needs this lesson. And I know you know this. When he says, almost jokingly, remember he was mocking a Southern accent when he said that. They didn't call me boy, they called me son. Well, the reason why they call a young white man son is because these segregationists, these racists, could see in him themselves. The reason why they would call black men boys was an attempt to establish the other, to dehumanize, to degrade them. Mm-hmm. And for him not to understand this and why people would take a deep offense to the way he used and dredged up this awful language. And this is the thing that we need: leaders that can bring us to more healing and more understanding. We all say in politics that we regret or things that didn't come out right or as we intended it. The fact that he's not apologizing and instead falls back into this thing.
And you correct them as quickly as possible. Can I just ask you about this? Because in his remarks last night, the part where he says that he didn't call him boy, a senior advisor says that he has told the story countless times and usually phrases it, he never called me senator, he called me son. Would it matter to you if he told that story differently?
No, what matters to me is that a guy running to be the head of our party, which is a significantly diverse and wondrous party, doesn't understand or can't even acknowledge that he made a mistake. Whether the intention was there or not, that's what was stunning to me. And instead, he's falling back into the defensive crouch that often people say, which is, Cory called me a racist, or I'm not a racist, which is not what I said, and not what I, not what I'm calling him. And this is the problem. He knows better. And at a time when Donald Trump never apologizes for anything and starts to create that kind of, toxic sentiment that you never apologize, never apologize, never apologize. I know Joe Biden. He's better than this. And this is a moment where he should have spoken to the issue, allowed everybody to learn from it and move on. Those are the kind of things a uniting leader, someone who heals and helps, would do. And this is a disappointment.
You're not comparing what Joe Biden said to the comments of
again, and absolutely not. I have a lot. I know Joe Biden. I know our vice president. I'm simply saying that for him not to acknowledge how many people are taking this as hurtful, to dredge up that word, to use it in the way he did, intended
or not. A simple thing, I should not have said that, would have been fine for you.
I should not have said that, even if he could have helped and acknowledged what it brings up, acknowledged the issue.
You know Simone Sanders, right? Simone Sanders is a senior advisor saying something very similar on Twitter tonight is what he said. He said, Joe Biden, does Joe Biden make a point that you need to sometimes work with people who staunchly disagree with or figure out how to work around them? So that's basically what she said.
Well, again, anybody knows my campaign knows the way I work. I work across the aisle all the time with people I could write dissertations on my disagreements with. Mm-hmm. This is not what we're talking about. We're talking about racial issues in America and how that there are still hurt and harm. There are still issues to be dealt with. And for someone to show the lack of understanding or sensitivity to even know when they've made a mistake and to fall into that kind of defensive posture and say, I'm not apologizing, that I should apologize to him, is really problematic.
So listen, this is, I think that you guys find yourselves in a very unusual position, meaning the Democratic Party, especially the candidates. When you have someone like Donald Trump in the White House who never apologizes, who says basically whatever he wants to say, no matter what. And then, I don't know what the former president thinks about this, but he says what he's concerned about is Democrats and the firing squad, the circular firing squad, that you guys are basically going to beat each other up more than the person you're running against, to meaning Donald Trump. Is there some truth in it for this particular
issue? This is beyond politics. And if I was not a presidential candidate, I would call something like this out. Look, I've had the reality of having a father, the indignity to watch another man call my father boy, to have myself have older men when I was a man. These are the kind of things that do cause hurt and harm. And these are the kind of things we should have an expectation of someone who's going to be the president of the United States, running for the president of the United States, seeking to be the leader of our party, can speak to. So this is not about our politics or our presidential campaign or a circular firing squad. This is a sensitivity. This is an issue that we need to speak to in this country and not sweep things under the rug. And if you want to put it in a political context, you know, there are communities like the one I live in that want to believe that we're going to have someone that's going to fight for them. He talks, even the way he talked about his sterling civil rights record, you know, he should speak to his record. But as someone who has seen what the 1994 crime bill did in communities like mine, this is a time not to try to fall back into sweeping statements, to try to talk to the issues that are still causing harm and still causing hurt, the language and the legislation. And for Joe Biden not to understand that he should be talking to these issues as someone who he aspires to be, that can heal this nation, bring it together, not to do the kind of insulting rhetoric that he used the other night.
Can I get you to clarify something? You said that it's problematic that he asked you to apologize. What do you mean by that specifically?
You know, the fact that he has said something that an African-American man could find very offensive, and then to turn around and say, you know, I'm not a racist, you should apologize to me. As opposed to, as Angela Davis used to say, that in a time of racism, it is not enough to say that I am not a racist. You need to be anti-racist. What we need from a former vice president, from a presidential candidate, what we need from each other is to be allies, to be seeking understanding, to be seeking empathy. None of us are perfect. We're all going to say things that are wrong, but to recognize that and to take the step that you need for healing and reconciliation to admit to that. So for his posture to be to me, I've done nothing wrong, you should apologize, I'm not a racist, is so insulting and so missing the larger point that he should not have to have explained to him, that this should not be a lesson that someone who's running for president of the United States should have to be given.